Sorry, some breaking news. The Subramanian Swamy has reacted to the DMK leader's allegations that the BJP is behind the turmoil in Tamil Nadu and that the BJP leaders are poaching ministers in Tamil Nadu. Listen in to Subramanian Swamy.
Sir, how do you answer to Mr. Stalin when he makes that allegation?
Well, Stalin is probably frustrated because his anti-Hindi thing didn't take off. Mm-hmm. Because the younger generation in Tamil Nadu wants to learn Hindi. Mm-hmm. Because they want to travel to different parts of India and get contracts, get a job, things like that. And there is a demand for the young Tamilians who are educated in engineering schools in the rest of India.
Right.
Because they appear to be more disciplined than other places. So there is a demand. It's all over the world. In fact, if you see most of the top positions in America.
But the allegation is very pointed. I mean, you never see the DMK coming for batting for AIADMK. Sure. They say that raid is on AIADMK and that is being done by BJP.
No, I am explaining why Mr. Stalin is so frustrated. Because their key thing on which they came to power in 1960s was Hindi. Now, having failed that, now he doesn't know what else to do. So what is the other something north, and that is BJP. That's their portrayal of BJP. Now, there's no BJP involvement whatsoever as a party. Yes, there are individuals. I take a lot of interest. I certainly would like to see the constitution implemented, and I think that what was done to the Anna DMK led by Sasikala was unconstitutional in most parts. I got one rectified, that is the government of Palaniswamy was able to be sworn in ultimately. This Paneerselvam has been acting as a stooge for whoever wants to break up Tamil Nadu.
But if I may ask you pointedly, because there's an allegation from Mr. Stalin as well that there's the IT raids that have been happening. Mr. Dinakaran is being arrested by Delhi Police Crime Branch. He has been taken back to Delhi after taking Chennai. So he's blaming BJP for all these things.
Well, I mean, there's no doubt that the Delhi Police is answerable to the Home Ministry. So it's easy to say that it must be the BJP is doing it. The fact of the matter is, of course, if Dinakar has committed any crime in terms of black money, that needs to be investigated. But that he tried to influence the election commission, that's a ridiculous charge, because the judgment of the election commission, interim judgment, was against Dinakaran's party. So what I would say is that Mr. Stalin is frustrated that everything he has done to topple the ADMK government has failed. He tried it on the floor by using rough stuff. They even roughed up the speaker. True. And ultimately had to escape punishment by contempt petitions by apologizing. True. So Hindi has failed. So now what does he do? He picks a soft target for Tamil Nadu, namely BJP.
So very final question. You say that BJP as a party is not responsible for the chaos.
Yes.
But does that mean that BJP, are there certain individuals within BJP who are taking extreme interest and who are probably responsible for the chaos, quote unquote?
Yes, I've been saying that for a long time. I'm taking undue interest, you can say. Apart from me, there are two ministers and one intellectual who's resident in Tamil Nadu. They've been hyperactive and they've been failing, but still they're not giving up.
All right, so there you heard BJP MP Subramanian Swamy lashing out at the DMK, saying that it's their frustration because their anti-Hindi agitation